Hello and welcome to New This Week on artistloud.com, the sound of independence. Today I have on the show someone who is an engineer by education, but then he went on to do what he loves the most. He's been voice to many, many Bollywood actors, has been singing for years, and today he's on the show to promote his album, Ramanesha. Welcome, Raman Mahadevan, as he would say. It's not Raman Mahadevan. So all you fans out there who think it's Raman Mahadevan, no, it's not Raman, it's Raman.
Yeah, that's the actual pronunciation. Yeah.
Right? That's the actual pronunciation. First of all, congratulations for the album.
Thank you.
I just want to know, why the name Ramanesha?
Ramanesha is Raman's world. You know, it's his own space. It's his own direction of thoughts. It's where he lives. So that's my world.
So it has nothing to do with the continent Asia.
Well, Asia, the actual meaning of Asia is peace. So you can say Raman is
Raman's
peace.
At peace.
Yeah.
Because he's a singer, he's at peace. But tell me, you know, did you always want to be a singer ever since childhood?
Not really. See, when you're growing up as a kid, at least me, I didn't have any vision in life. I would say...
Like any other graduate or a school kid, you don't know what to do.
Yeah, you don't know. When you see cricket, you want to be a cricketer. When you see a painter, you want to be a painter. So you start liking everything as a normal kid, you know. So I think it was college, degree college, when I thought, I used to participate in competitions and stuff. So that's where I thought, you know, I might be a bit better than the normal average singers, you know.
Right.
And maybe I have a future.
So then that is where you thought that, oh, you know what, I think I can do much better than what is being played around you, or you realized that ek backup plan bana le.
Well, it was not a backup plan, I would say. I really was serious in getting into music. But then fate had something else in mind. I mean, wo kehte hain ki, you know, jab chaha tab nahi milta, fir shayad wo thode thode.
No, they say that life is, you know, what happens to you when you're busy making other plans.
Exactly, maybe.
Yeah.
you could say that.
Yeah.
Then I moved out of college. Then I started off searching for contacts, people, meeting people, giving them my cassettes, which I would still be honest, that wasn't that great. So makes more sense that, you know, why...
Why they didn't take you in first
place. Exactly.
Okay.
So...
Kin ke dwar khatkhataya aapne?
A lot of people, yeah. I mean, those days, Sandeep Chadha was quite happening. I went to his place. Met Rehman Saab, Shankar Ehsaan Loy. Yeah, to name a few.
मतलब हर एक के आपने दरवाजे खटखटा डाले, दूध वाला, सर मेरा कैसेट. Have you done something like that?
Yeah.
Have you actually?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I've done that to Shankar.
Okay, you done Shankar that to Shankar. What did you do?
I just walked up at his place and, you know, sir, I'm so and so, and, you know, here I want to play. He was quite peaceful in that space. You know, he was quite nice to me.
Yeah.
So he said, okay, please come in. So that
then,
was,
then you
I was
sang
lucky.
For him? Then you sang for him?
Yeah, I played him my tape.
Okay.
Yeah.
What was his reaction?
He said, yeah, it was nice. I mean, like, first of all, sachai ye thi ki wo time pe zyada experience nahi tha. It was very raw. Polishing nahi tha voice mein. So he said, yeah, keep working. It's nice, you know.
Yeah, you actually got it the right. Yeah, it's nice and you can do it. Yeah. That's how Shankar talks.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and then he said, ke, मैंने आपका गाना सुना, मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा, आप यहाँ आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, आप जा सकते हैं और दूध वाले के अंदर भेज दीजिए फाइनली. सो दैट हैपेंड, यू नो. एंड बट डिड यू टेक एनी ट्रेनिंग बिफोर एक्चुअली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग दैट कैसेट?
या आई हैव लर्न्ड कर्नाटिक क्लासिकल म्यूजिक, दैट्स बीन माय बैकग्राउंड
राइट सिंस द एज ऑफ
10 12 आई थिंक.
सो दैट मींस यू वर वेरी सीरियस कि मुझे इतना तो कुछ करना ही है, संगीत में ही करूंगा.
या
एंड देन यू वेंट टू एन आईटी बैकग्राउंड बिकॉज़ थिंग्स वर नॉट हैपनिंग फॉर यू इन म्यूजिक.
या to be honest, yeah, one year I met up people, just ended up meeting, making contacts, you know. Then I said, boss, bahut ho gaya, I can't keep borrowing money from my dad, you know, I need to earn. So I joined the IT industry. It was a MNC where I was working as a quality control engineer.
Okay.
That's how I worked there for like 3 years. Meanwhile, a lot of shows happened, live shows happened, where I started performing mostly in the Gujarati circuit. You know?
Okay.
So I did a lot of Navratri shows.
How did that happen? A South Indian boy moving into a Gujarati circuit?
I don't know.
Okay.
So it's just that...
Giving Falguni Pathak a run for her money.
No, not really. I mean,
Can you sing a line in Gujarati? I know, I'm sure you know.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, what is that?
I learned a lot. Tari aankhno afini, tara bolno bandhani, tara roopni punamno pagal eklo. Something like that.
What does that mean?
Don't ask. I mean, like, it describes the beauty of a girl, you know,
right.
Basically. God willingly, I got more avenues. I started doing jingles. Kafi radio ads kiye, TV commercials kiye. And very lucky to start my jingle career with Bachchan Saab, you know, a Pepsi ad. Where
that was your first jingle?
Yeah, that was one of my earliest jingles which I did. Then happened Mirinda, Lays and a lot of more projects. So it was quite a booster for me. And I was gradually in touch with Shankar as well. So Shankar called me in 2002 for one of his shows as a backup vocalist.
Right.
I think it was just after Dil Chahta I became really big.
Right.
You know? And so he was like, yeah, we'll do a lot more shows in life and all that. But finally, yeah, we started off on a gradual basis from 2004 onwards.
Okay.
And 2006 was the first time he said, I have a song for you. That's right. How the first movie, Hey Baby, happened for me.
Rock On happened.
Yeah, Tare Zameen Par happened.
Tare Zameen Par happened. And Tare Zameen Par happened. Is that where Aamir actually got note of you? And you have an association with him and Satyamev Jayate. And I want you to highlight that for your fans.
Yeah. Satyamev Jayate happened quite recently. Like, as I said, I've been in the ad industry and where I do multiple languages.
Right.
So, this coordinator friend of mine, Manohar Nayak, who, you know, he called me and he said, you know, there's this job, Aamir and Ram Sampath, they want you to do this particular song in the South languages because it's been simultaneously telecasted in
all across. Yeah.
So I said, yeah, wow, that's a good opportunity. And I heard that and I love the song, which is originally sung by Kirti Sagatia.
Okay.
Brilliant singer himself. So, yeah, it was fun.
So you sang the Tamil version of the
song? Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam and Kannada.
So sing, how many languages do you actually sing in?
Whichever you can coordinate me with, like, you know.
That was smart.
Yeah.
Why did you decide to take out an album?
Well, it was not to prove a point. Mm. It was just, you know, I like to compose a bit, you know, in my free time. So I had some compositions which I thought might work. So, aur aise karte karte kaafi sare gaane ho gaye. So maine bola kyun nahi main inko ek compile karke ek album banao. And it was all different songs of different space. As in, ek romantic hai, to ek is about just about nature. It's about, one is about a fantasy. One is exactly opposite, like very angst wala. So I said, chalo ek compile karke main banata hu. So I got in touch with my friends Amit Trivedi and Amitabh Bhattacharya.
Right. Amazing people
amazing
in their own right.
In their own right and most sought after right now in the industry. So, and they said, yeah, definitely we'll help you out. Amit was very sweet. He produced the whole album.
Wow.
As in, musically, he produced the whole album. And Amitabh, he wrote, I think, five of those songs, eight songs. So, finally, it got made and I went to the company. But unfortunately, the companies were not in that space. And at that time, piracy was at the peak.
Yep.
The companies, music companies just had a taste of their piracy, of the piracy, you know.
Right.
And they were going into loss. So, they said, you know, ye gana film mein achha lag raha hai, you know. I can visualize a Shah Rukh Khan singing this song. But, you know, as an album, I don't think iska kuch zyada life hai. So, that was the irony. I said, fair enough. So, I released it on an online site called Soundbus, which was a Singapore-based company. That's where I released the company. This was in 2007.
Okay.
Then the site was...
also went into losses and...
Went into losses. They closed shop.
Yeah.
So then I happened to meet Soumini from Artists Aloud, Hangama. She said, why not use your songs in our arena? So I said, fair enough.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
So right now, I want you to sing one of the songs from the album. So, kaun sa gana aap sabse pehle...
I think the most earliest compositions which happened to me was Teri Talash Hai.
Teri Talash Hai.
Yeah. I was a broken hearted then. So.
Toote hue dil se sangeet nikla hai.
Yeah. Blue toote hue. So I happened to pen this down and just composed it. Ghar pe baithe baithe. It went like, you know. Kabhi to aise mile the ke jaise pehle nahi. देखा था मैंने भी तुझे ख्वाबों में, अब जीऊं मैं या मरूं तेरे संग मैं रहूं, मुझको तो है अब तेरी कसम. Something like that.
So let's add some music to this.
Yeah.
And let's get the lights.
Yeah.
Let's get the camera rolling.
Yeah.
Let's have his performance. That was amazing. So tell me, you know, because it gave me a feel of a, like a college day trip.
Yeah.
And those days, the music is like that.
Yeah.
And you also told us that you were in that zone.
Yeah.
So मैंने ये देखा है कि क्या वाकई में एक संगीतकार को दुख से गुजरना पड़ता है इस तरह के खूबसूरत नगमे क्रिएट करने के लिए.
Well, जहाँ तक संगीत का सवाल है, संगीत is a completely different thing altogether. वैसे as a human being, you go through sorrows, you go through happiness. And if you're a musician, you end of the day, you're a human being, you know?
Yeah.
So it comes, it translates into music.
हम जज्बाती ज़्यादा होते हैं संगीत का.
Maybe. वो translate हो जाता है.
तो जब आपने ये लिखा, तो वो दर्द कितने दिनों तक चला था?
शायद एक दो तीन महीने.
दो तीन महीने. तो आपने कहा भैया दर्द हो रहा है, पहले तो सबसे पहले उसका फायदा उठाया जाए, दो चार गाने लिखे जाए. कुछ और भी लिखे आपने गाने उस
नहीं, I think this was the only
एक ही गाना.
Yeah.
तो मैं ये जानना चाहूंगा जिनके लिए लिखा था या जिनकी वजह से लिखा था, क्या उन्हें पता ये गाना उनकी वजह से है? क्या उन्होंने कोई रॉयल्टी के नाम पे कुछ क्रेडिट मांगा?
नहीं.
या व्हाट वाज हर रिएक्शन?
Well, she liked it.
She liked it.
And we passed up.
Well, तभी कहते हैं कि जो संगीत है वो बिछड़े हुओं को मिला देता है, टूटे हुए दिलों को जोड़ देता है.
Correct.
क्या बात है? This is going interesting. Well, we're going to carry off this interesting conversation on the other side of the break. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned.
Anu Malik.
Anu Malik साहब.
एक गरम चाय की प्याली हो. ये गाना मैंने बनाया.
उमड़ घुमड़ घनघोर बरसे ये शाम रंग बदरा, जैसे कि बिजुरी का हो बांधा घटाओं ने गजरा.
Think you're a character, you're like a Shahrukh on
you
top
love Shahrukh Khan, right?
Not really.
वो अंधेरी रात की चाप थी जो गुजर गई, वो अंधेरी रात की चाप थी जो गुजर गई. कभी खिड़कियों पे ना झुक सकी, किसी रास्ते में ना रुक सकी। उसे जाने किसकी तलाश थी, मेरी आंख ओस से तर रही, मुझे ख्वाब बुनने की लत रही। कभी एक सूनी सी रह गुजर पे खड़ा था मैं, कभी दूर रेल की पटरियों पे पड़ा था मैं।
Hi friends, this is Nebula the Band, and the album which we are going to record today is known as Nebula the Band Volume 1.
Ibadat tera ishq, tere ishq mein har khushi, jiya nahi laake tere bina, sang tera bhai mohe itna piya.
Don't forget to catch us this Thursday 4 PM on artistallowed.com.
Welcome back after the break, and I have with me the very talented, and actually it's quite surprising that he never talks this much, Raman. Now I'm going to talk about this album, Raman Asia.
Yeah.
When you actually came up with the idea that, you know, this is the album I'm going to take out, so were you also going through a phase, or you deliberately decided that these are the kind of songs I want in an album?
Yeah, I was quite, when we were going through the process of producing the album, Amit gave me a lot of suggestions. Hmm. Even Amitabh gave me a lot of suggestions. Hmm. They were quite strong about one thing, that, you know, see, it's a good thing you have different kind of songs in this, which is a different way to look at it. But normally, albums have a similar color, you know. So this is, us hisab mein, this is Hatke.
Okay.
This is different from the kind of albums which is happening.
Right.
So it's like a 50-50 chance it can work, it could not work.
What was your belief?
It might work.
It might work. Yeah. So you were also in that dilemma.
Yeah, otherwise I wouldn't have gone to the extent of putting in my money and producing the whole thing.
How difficult is it to produce an album like this in today's scenario?
If you're talented enough, you can produce it sitting at home, you know.
Yeah.
If you're that talented. But then, see, it is a costly expense if you're looking to do a good quality project, you know.
But because you had friends, good friends, pooling in, a lot of things became easier.
Yeah,
yeah. So it was Amit and?
Amitabh Bhattacharya and Shelly.
And how many times would you fight ke yaar, main kuch aur soch raha hun, yaar, tum kuch aur soch raha hun?
Ek do baar hua. Ek gaana tha called O Meri Jaan.
O Meri Jaan.
Yeah. So I had sung it and, aur mera ek vision tha us gaane mein. I wanted this kind of a rhythm, this kind of a melody backing it. Amit did a whole jazzy version of it. And initially I was like, kya kar diya yaar, tune yaar? And he was shocked that I couldn't interpret his feelings at that particular time. But then it grew on me and I said, Amit, I love this version of you.
Oh, so you fell in love with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
It grew on me.
It grew on you.
Yeah.
But now if you look back at it, do you think that your version was better?
No way.
No way at all?
No way.
Okay, so you want to say sorry to Amit?
Sorry, Amit, I didn't believe you the first time.
But, you know, I want to ask you about another song in the, it's known as Badra.
Yeah.
Right? Tell me something more about the song.
Badra is like a fantasy song for me. Hmm. It's like, you're a character. You're like a Shah Rukh.
You love Shah Rukh Khan, right?
Not really.
Not really, okay. He's the god of love.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
For everybody on this planet Earth, he's the God of love.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, you're top of a train, open train like a chair.
Chaiya.
Yeah? And you're going to your native place.
Oh.
Just think the scenario, and it's raining. And it's all green, and you're falling in love with the rains, basically. So, Bhadra is that kind of a track. It's like loving the rains.
But surely on this stage, we can allow you to perform another song.
Super.
And we would love to hear Bhadra.
Super.
So, let's have Bhadra. Song, and in fact, जब आप वो गाना गा रहे थे तो मुझे खुद भी ये लगा कि मैं भी ट्रेन पे छैया छैया कर रहा हूँ. In fact, बदरा कर रहा हूँ.
बदरा
कर रहा हूँ. Okay, I want to know more about your album. So we heard two songs. What else is there?
There's one song which is like a fight within yourself. The lyrics are wonderfully written by Amitabh. It's like मत तोड़ो मुझे मत जोड़ो मुझे. एक राज हूँ मैं. क्या मैं आग हूँ क्या मैं आग हूँ. Like am I water or am I fire?
Right.
So it's all contradicting statements in that, you know. So it's keeping the human tendency in perspective, you know. Aap shayad kabhi kabhi sahi bhi hote hain, kabhi kabhi galat bhi hote hain. So maybe it's the grey matter song, you know, in the album. So, so dark one.
Raman Mahadevan, kya wo aag hain ki kya wo pani
hai? No, I think I'm in between.
Matlab main pani mein jalti hui aag hoon.
Wah.
Kya baat hai? Matlab tadakti bhadakti cheez hoon.
Yeah.
If you look within yourself, how many times are you right and how many times are you wrong?
70% wrong, 30% right.
70% wrong? Yeah. Why do you say that?
Then I learn from those mistakes, then I try to, you know, the whole cycle keeps on going on.
Talking about those mistakes,
yeah.
Tell me three mistakes of your life.
First is, I still think that I should have continued my vocal lessons as a kid. Like, you know, I used to look for other pastures, like, you know, cricket mein zyada dhyan tha, isme tha, wo tha. एक इसमें स्टक रहता तो शायद मैं थोड़ा और आई वुड हैव यू नो हैड लिटिल मोर नॉलेज इन लाइफ.
ओके.
वन सेकंड आई फील दैट आई शुडंट हैव वेस्टेड दोस 2-3 इयर्स इन द एमएनसी बट देन लाइफ हैपेंड टू यू. आई स्टिल फील दैट यू नो आई कुड हैव यूज्ड दोस 3 इयर्स स्ट्रगलिंग मोर इन द इंडस्ट्री.
सो व्हाट्स द थर्ड वन?
थर्ड आई डोंट नो येट.
लेट मी गो टू थिंक. व्हाई डोंट यू थिंक अबाउट इट एंड आई एम गोना टेक अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक. वेल वी हैव रमन विद अस एंड वी गोना टॉक अबाउट हिज म्यूजिक हिज लाइफ एंड वन मोर मिस्टेक ही मेड इन हिज लाइफ. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned.
अरे क्या कर रहे हो ये लेकर तुम बैठे हो ये कार्ड फेंक दो इसको.
Okay.
पर पतों से आज मैं टकरा गया. गुंचे नहीं खिलने लगे डालियों पे दिल.
Good evening, friends. Are you ready to get recharged? We're here to rock you.
Dak, 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 dak kachkajin dum kachkajin kachkajin dum kachkajin kachkajin dum kachkajin kachkajin dum kachkajin dum kachkajin dum kachkajin dum kachkajin dum
I'm an Indian tabla player and multi-percussionist from Mumbai. What you just witnessed, my friends, was my band Recharge performing in the world-famous Woodstock Festival in 2008 for a huge crowd of 400,000 people. Recharge is a confluence of the best of the world's music, be it Indian, with African, Latin, jazz, and also Western classical music. Recharge combines the best of the world's music and genres in a unique combination and concept in every song. And what better way to combine the best of the world's music than through its heartbeat percussion? Recharge presents an impressive array of percussion instruments from across the world.
After the break, I have with me Raman Mahadevan, and before the break, we were talking about three mistakes of his life, and he told us two. What's the third one?
I think I was too late to learn driving. People used to ask me, "Or tu chala leta na gaadi? Kaunsi gaadi hai?" I used to like, sorry, not my cup of tea.
But you know, I also want to talk to you about the various genres of music you sing in. So, what all genres do you sing in?
See, there was a time when there used to be Hindustani classical and Carnatic classical, I mean, अभी भी है, and इनका कुछ bifurcations होता था हिंदी films में, अभी भी होता है, but I think the indie pop culture died, because film music is doing it all.
So you've also sung for various movies, and which has been the most memorable experience for you?
I would still count on the first one, Hey Baby, because being my first song, तो Shankar played me the song in his voice, and I said wow, I enjoyed singing it completely.
Do you mimic as well? No, they say singers mimic easily.
A bit, yeah.
Tell me, who do you mimic the most?
Some singers I do.
Some singers?
Yeah, some actors.
Some actors. Yeah. So let's have a couple of them.
Wow, kya kar rahe yaar?
Something like that.
Okay, so that's Saif.
Yeah.
So.
Arre kya kar rahe ho, ye lekar tum baithe ho, ye card. Phek do isko.
That's Kulbhushan Kharbanda.
Yes.
Yeah. And singers?
Shabir Kumar.
Shabir Kumar sahab, parbaton se.
Yeah.
Haan ji.
Parbaton se aaj main takra gaya.
Something like that.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And anybody of the current era?
Anu Malik.
Anu Malik sahab.
Ek garam chai ki pyaali ho, ye gaana maine banaya.
Something
that was amazing. So, you know, I could actually gauge a lot of, there's a lot of talent. लड़के में बड़ा दम है, इसके पास गाने थोड़े कम हैं, इसको गाने और दो. There's another song in your album which is Gunche.
Gunche.
What does that mean?
Gunche means a flock, as in a bunch.
Okay.
So it's my love for nature which comes through Amitabh's words in it, you know. Beautiful words he has written. It's like Gunche naye khilne lage daliyon pe dil mein. So it's a peaceful song. It's one of our favorite songs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's have a performance of the song Gunche. Song. I want to know more about your future projects now.
Future projects, there are a couple of films. One is, I've done some vocal things for Amit in a couple of his films. Then there's an international collaboration with a musician called Jirka. He's from Czech Republic.
Okay.
So I've done a project with him.
Right. Tell me something, you know, you launched your album on artslot.com.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're also singing for Bollywood.
Yeah.
Things have changed in this digital space. Today, your voice reaches out to millions of people across the globe.
Perfectly.
And in real time. So, what is your take on that?
Ek time hua karta tha when you used to wait for a cassette release.
Right.
Yeah. Or we had to go buy the CD, physical CD. Now, you can just download it.
And it's available on each of the gadgets you use.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. And you have apps.
Yeah.
Apps dedicated to each artist. You
right.
Know? So, अगर मुझे सोनू निगम के गाने चाहिए तो मैं कैन जस्ट गो एंड दिस हैपन डाउनलोड हिज सॉन्ग्स
राइट
लाइक दैट
राइट
सो इट्स सुपर्ब
आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन हाउ वुड यू लव टू बी नोन
लाइक अ नॉर्मल म्यूजिशियन आई वुड से
नो देयर हैज टू बी वन एंड आई एम श्योर यू नो एवरी परफॉर्मर हैज हिज ड्रीम दैट दिस इज हाउ आई वांट टू बी नोन एंड
आई डोंट हैव अ ड्रीम येट आई वुड से आई एम स्टिल इन द स्पेस ऑफ फिगरिंग
You're just flowing with the life.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yeah. And I wish you loads of luck.
Thank you
And
so
I would
much.
Love to catch up with you very soon.
Sure.
When you have a big dream.
Yeah.
And I would love to hear it from you, what that dream is.
Superb.
Thank you for being on the show,
Thank
Raman.
You so much.
And that was Raman Mahadevan. I'm going to catch you up next Monday, only on artslot.com, The Sound of Independence. Looking absolutely gorgeous. But the word Shruti in Urban Dictionary means hot, naughty, and someone who has an attitude to go with it.
I have been born and brought up with, you know, classical music and Hindi music, you know. So I do have a very Indian touch to my singing.
Meri rehmata teri chahta tere naal hi bas rafta.
Sufi is not a type of music. Sufi is a feeling.
Tere naal hi bas rafta.
As my first single, I didn't want a hit song. I just wanted something real.
Ishq ke nache main raj ke vipavaniyo thak de.
Do not forget to catch me live this Monday, 4 p.m. only on artistallowed.com, where it's music first.
Meri rehmata teri chahta tere naal hi bas rafta.